and the timekeeper, and the audience?
Yes.
Then I will begin. Imagine with me a young man sitting in his apartment writing a note. A note to whoever might care enough to read it. This young man is thinking about doing the unthinkable. As he wipes away a tear from his eye, he looks down at his paper and reads aloud what he wrote. I'm going to walk to the Golden Gate Bridge. If one person smiles at me on the way, I will not jump. As he walked, he looked for someone to smile at him. But apparently, no one did. What is one thing that transcends all language barriers? What is one simple act that can express so many words without even having to verbally say those words? And what is one small part of you that can change someone's life in a matter of seconds? What is it? It's a smile. But the question is, do you use your smile? Stop and think. You got up this morning and you got ready for the day, but have you smiled today? Sadly, we live in a society where we're also caught up in our jobs and our educations that we miss the small things in life, like smiles. But a simple smile is a very small way you can brighten someone's day without even knowing it. Today, I'm here to demonstrate to you the power of your smile. I'll answer three questions. First, how can a smile change someone else's life? Secondly, how do you smile if you don't feel like it? And lastly, what was God's purpose in giving us smiles? So let's begin with the first question. How can a smile change someone else's life? In the beginning of this speech, I told a story about a young man who was looking for a smile. This story, which is taken from a blog post entitled If One Person Smiles by Catherine Gray, is just one example of how you can change someone's life by smiling at them. Now you might be thinking, what are the odds of me changing someone's life with a smile? Well, according to the results of a poll that are in an article entitled What Makes Most People Happy by Mark Dolber, 1/3 of Americans are happy. This in turn means 2/3 of Americans are unhappy. So let's say you pass 15 people per day. According to these numbers, 10 of those people are unhappy. What can we do to change this? Smile. Because you don't know what is making those people unhappy. He might have just found out he has cancer. She might have just lost a loved one in a car accident. He might have just been foreclosed on. They just might be considering suicide. And what do we do more often than not? We just pass by them like they're just another person. But if you choose to smile, you just might show them that there is hope, and that there are people out there that care, and that there are people out there that still smile. So smile! For those 10 out of 15 people that you were going to pass right when you walk out of that door, that you don't know what is going on in their lives, but your smile can make their situations just a little easier to deal with. Your smile is infectious. So start contaminating people with it today. Now that you know how your smile could change someone else's life, you might be thinking, how do I smile if I don't feel like it? Well, the secret to smiling more is knowing that it is frequently a choice that we have to make. As Abraham Lincoln once said, most folks are about as happy as they make up their minds to be. You have to make up your mind to be happy or you will end up becoming unfriendly. How do you make up your mind to be happy? You look for the things you have to smile about instead of the things you have to frown about. If you choose to be happy on the inside, it will show on the outside. And the way it shows on the outside is through your smile. In Proverbs 15:13, it says, a joyful heart makes a face cheerful, but a sad heart produces a broken spirit. Choose to make your heart joyful and happy, and it will create a happy and joyful smile that can change someone's life. Another way you can choose to be happy is by adjusting your posture. According to communicatebetter.blogspot.com, if a person slouches a lot, they will feel more sluggish and grumpy as compared to a person who has good posture. So if you find yourself struggling to be happy, sit in an upright position. Think about the things you have to smile about, and I know a smile will be the result. Now that you know how to smile when you don't feel like it, let me cover my third and final point. What was God's purpose in giving us smiles? Well, I believe that there are two reasons that God gave us smiles. First, he gave them to us to encourage each other. And secondly, he wanted us to use them to worship him. Now, I already talked about how you can change someone's life by smiling at them, so I'm going to go directly into the second reason why God gave us smiles, to use them to worship him. Psalm 32:11 says, "Be glad in the Lord and rejoice, you righteous ones. Shout for joy, all you upright in heart." In the previous point about smiling when you don't feel like it, I talked about making up your mind to have a joyful heart, which results in a smile. In this verse, God is asking us to shout for joy because of what he has done for us. I think it's almost impossible to have joy without having a smile on your face. In order to shout for joy and to praise the Lord, you must have a smile. That's why God gave us these powerful facial expressions. The Lord desires to see your smile because it is the beginning of worship. You probably already noticed this, but I am very passionate about smiles. I could go on and on for days and days about people smiling more, but for time's sake and for your sake, I won't do that. But before we move on to my summary and conclusion, I just want to tell you something about this speech. Every single word that I have said and that I will say has been prayerfully written. I believe that God wrote this speech, not me. And I have been praying for each of you ever since God laid this on my heart. I pray for all of you since last July has been that you and you and you will leave this room with more joy in your heart and with a bigger desire to share that joy with other people that need it through your beautiful, beautiful smiles. That being said, since I covered so much in my points, I just want to have a short little recap. First, I talked about how your smile could change someone else's life. I mentioned how you don't know what other people are going through and how your smile could make their hard times easier. Secondly, I talked about how to smile if you don't feel like it. I said that the secret to being happy is knowing that it is a choice. And lastly, I talked about why God gave us smiles. I said that I believe God gave us smiles to encourage each other and to worship him. This last July when I started working on this speech, I did something kind of crazy. I took an old piece of cardboard and I made a sign that said, "Let me see your smile. Hook up your smile." And I took this sign and I stood in three of the busiest parts of town, smiling and waving at everyone that passed by. After holding this sign for a total of 1 hour, 152 people honked at me. I also got many thumbs up, a lady screaming that she loved me, many, many smiles, and a job offer. I think with that being said, it shows that one simple act, 1 hour of your life, can make so many people. I'd like to close today with a quote from a man named Leo Buscalia, who is an author, a motivational speaker, and a professor with a PhD in special education. Quote, "Too often do we underestimate the power of a touch, a smile, a kind word, a listening ear, an honest compliment, or the smallest act of caring. All of which have the potential to turn a life around." End quote. You have the potential to turn a life around in a matter of seconds with just one smile. That is the power of your smile. Thank you.